Hey, grade 10. Today we'll be learning about nonlinear simultaneous equations. The strategy we are going to use for nonlinear is going to be substitution. Okay, so there's not much different from the last video that Mr. Majid did with you guys. But we're going to be focused, but whenever you do nonlinear, you should do substitution for those types of problems. All right, so here we have example one. We have y squared minus 4x is equal to 0, which is our nonlinear, and 2x plus y is equal to 4, which is our linear. Like I said before, the best strategy and the most practical strategy to use is to substitute, okay? Now, for when it comes to both these equations, the best thing to solve for is our linear, okay? And then we can substitute it back into our nonlinear, all right? So let's go ahead and solve. Again, best thing to solve is just for our y, since it's y itself as well. Okay, so let's go ahead and solve for y. What we have to do is minus 2x, y ends up being -2x plus 4. All right, so I know what y is. Well, I can use this to my advantage by substituting it back in for my nonlinear equation. Okay, let's go ahead and do that right now. So we have y squared minus 4x is equal to 0. Well, I do know y is equivalent to -2x plus 4, so I'll substitute that for y. Right. All right, I do have to FOIL here, okay? I'm hoping you guys remember. I'll do this real quick, just off to the side. But that's FOIL, first, outside, inside, last. Okay, let's combine the terms. All right, so I FOILed. Go ahead and put that in for -2x plus 4 squared. Okay, and I have -4x is equal to 0. All right, let's clean this up a bit. Okay, let's combine like terms. I have -16x and -4x. Those are like terms that I can combine. Okay, so I have 4x, which is the 4x squared by itself, -20x. Plus 16, okay? Now make sure everything is equal to 0 because you will end up factoring. The number one rule for factoring is to find your GCF first. Okay, so between 4x squared, -20x, and plus 16, what is common, what is the greatest common factor between all three of these? Well, that would end up being 4, correct? So 4, and I end up having x squared minus 5x. Plus 4 is equal to 0. Okay, let's go ahead and factor now. We find our GCF. How do we factor x squared minus 5x plus 4? Well, what multiplies to 4? It also adds up to negative 5. That would end up being negative 4 and negative 1. Okay, all right, now, what we can do is solve for x, okay? Now x minus 4 is equal to 0, so let's go ahead and solve for that. So x minus 4 is equal to 0, x would be 4. X minus 1 equal to 0, that would end up being x is equal to 1. Okay, so now I have both values for x. We're gonna plug these back in just a second. Just find out what their corresponding y is. All right, so we did end up getting x is equal to 4, x is 1. Okay, all we have to do is plug, since we know our x values, we'll go ahead and plug that in into one of those equations. Now, easiest thing to plug in these values is our linear equation, so let's go ahead and plug that in. Now remember, we said we solved for y here, so this is actually y is equal to -2x plus 4, right? But it doesn't really matter, you can use either of those equations, okay? So, when we do substitute it back in, okay? When x is 4, okay, what do we end up getting? We end up getting -8 plus 4, y ends up being -4. Okay, so when x is 4, y is negative 4. When we plug 1 back in, okay, negative 2 plus 4 is equal to a positive 2, so y is equal to 2 when x is 1. Okay, now we would like you to have these in coordinate form as well. Okay, so this would end up being, your both answers would be 4, negative 4, okay, and 1, 2. Okay, those are in coordinate form.
Hey guys, we are from the PhD tutoring program. The program is designed to help improving your understanding in certain subjects such as math or biology. The tutors will help you deal with the parts that you're having problems with in class. It does not only help you to have a better academic achievement, but also improve the relationships between peers. If you're interested, you can pick up a form at the student services or talk to your counselor. This program will take place in a library in Pier 7 on the day you decide. Please come and join our program. We are more than welcome to help you. See you all then.
All right, so here we have example 2. Again, the strategy we're going to use is substitution. All right, the best thing to solve for and then substitute later back into your nonlinear equation is equation number 2. So let's solve for y. All right, if we solve for y, we end up getting negative 3x, add 8 to the other side. Y ends up being y is equal to negative 3x plus 8. So we know that for y, every time we see y, when we substitute back in, we replace it with negative 3x plus 8. Okay, so that's what's going in right here. Right? I will rewrite this again just so you guys can see it once more. Right? I do know y is replaced with negative 3x plus 8. Again, and as you can see, we will be foiling this again. Right? So again, if you're having trouble with foiling, I will do it one more time, just off to the side. So first, negative 3x, inside, negative 24x, outside, negative 24x, and last, negative 64, right? We can simplify here, 9x squared, negative 54x, sorry, not 54, 48x, plus 64, right? So, that is equivalent to 9x squared, negative 48x, plus 64, and then plus 3x squared is equal to 28, right? So, let's combine my terms here. I can combine 9x squared and 3x squared. That would end up making 12x squared. I have negative 48x plus 64 is equal to 28, right? Everything has to be on one side, so it has to be equal to 0 minus 28 minus 28. I end up having 12x squared negative 48x plus 36 is equal to 0, okay? Number one rule of factoring is to do what? Find your GCF first. I do have a GCF, 12 goes into each term. Okay, so take out 12 out of each. Then we end up having x squared, 4 minus 4x plus 3 is equal to 0. All right, now think about factor. How can I factor this? What multiplies the 3 that adds up to negative 4? That would end up being negative 3 and negative 1. All right, now set both of these equal to 0. X minus 3 equal to 0, that would mean x is equal to 3. X minus 1 equal to 0, that would mean x is equal to 1. Okay, so we have both our x values. We just have to go ahead and plug these in to find our what our y values are. All right, so we have our values for x and or both our x values. Okay, let's go ahead and plug it in. And when we plug it in, let's use the easier equation so we can find y much more easily. Okay, so I end up having, let's plug it into our linear equation. Let's plug in x plus y minus 8 is equal to 0. 3 times 3 is 9, 9 minus 8. I have y plus 1 equal to 0. Y ends up being a negative 1, okay? Right up here, I have x is 1, so that's what I'm substituting in, right? 3 times 1 is 3, 3 minus 8 is negative 5, so y minus 5 equal to 0. Y ends up being a positive 5, so when x is 1, y is 5, and when x is 3, y is equal to negative 1. Okay. All right, so here is your practice problem for today. We'll see you guys tomorrow.